Hi, I'm Giulia Lombardo, and today I'm going to be showing you how to make the perfect charcuterie and cheese board, and what better place to start than at Bosa Foods. What a great selection of meats, cheeses, and condiments. Today I think I'll go with a preferisco brazzola and fennel salami, a serrano ham, and a chorizo. Let's head up to the test kitchen. There are two ways to get started. One is to start with the meat, and one is to start with the cheese. So we've already chosen out our meats, now let's talk about pairings. The first pairing that I like to go with, which is the easiest, I like to think about regions. So we're going to start with our serrano ham here. It's nice and thin. I'm gonna put it in the corner. You wanna arrange it in kind of a loose fashion. You don't wanna squish it. So kind of like a little bit of a fanning motion. And I'm gonna pair the serrano with an aged manchego from Spain. And I'm gonna cut this in half, just because I want it to be a little bit more manageable on the plate. You always want to cut cheeses in a triangle, and you always want to try to preserve that rind. So that's going to go beside each other. To go with the serrano and the manchego, I'm going to use some Marcona almonds that are really, really nice. They're almost buttery a little bit, and they've got a really nice crunch and a little bit of saltiness. And then to offset those two flavors, I'm going to use a quince jam. So it's going to be really nice and sweet. Quince is kind of similar to a pear, so it's going to go really well with the manchego. Now, keeping with the theme of regions, I'm going to pair the fennel salami with an Italian pecorino. And I'm going to pair these on the opposite side of the board. Kind of same idea, you kind of just want to let the meat kind of fan out. And I'm going to put the pecorino right beside. So pecorino is a really nice, semi-mild, soft cheese. Then I'm gonna add some olives to go with that, just to give it a little bit of tanginess. Another way of thinking of pairings is that opposites attract. So today we're using a really high quality chorizo. This is a chorizo ibérico de bellota. It's from a special region in Spain where the pigs are allowed to roam free and they eat primarily acorns, which results in an extremely high quality and unique product. So today we're pairing this really nice and rich chorizo with a very creamy and delicate goat's cheese. This goat's cheese is packed in olive oil and there's a little bit of herbs in there. So we're gonna keep the goat's cheese in this little bowl, and I'm just going to put the slices of the chorizo around the goat's cheese. When you're slicing the chorizo, you wanna make sure you get it as thin as possible so that it can melt in your mouth. And to complement the spicy chorizo and the goat's cheese, I'm going to put a little chunk of honeycomb. That's going to really offset the richness of the chorizo. My third method, which is my favorite, it's choose whatever you like. Choose whatever meat looks good to you or your favorite cheese, and you know what? It's gonna be delicious no matter what. So for our last pairing, we're doing a brazzola, which is an air-dried beef. It's a really nice addition to a charcuterie board when you have mostly pork items. So we're just gonna put this on the plate. We're gonna be filling up these empty spaces. And then I'm pairing this brazzola with a taleggio, which is a cow's milk cheese. It's fairly mild and has a soft rind, so it pairs well with other cheeses and meats. Another classic addition to a cheese and meat board, we have some dried figs here. You can really use any type of dried fruit. Apricots also work very well. And as part of our finishing touch, we're going to drizzle some balsamic glaze. This is going to add a really nice sweetness and a little bit of acidity to the plate. Now for a little bit of a fresh element, we're going to add some fresh figs. If you don't have fresh figs, you could also use grapes. Apples always work really well too. I also have some nectarines here that I'm just going to fan out. It's okay to start overlapping if you're running out of space. And then I have some really cute little golden raspberries that I'm just gonna put right beside the almonds. And then lastly, we're going to be adding some edible flower petals. And just kind of sprinkle wherever they land, looks really pretty. And I think that's perfect. I'm going to serve this with an assortment of crackers found right here at Bosa Foods, where you can also buy all of these key ingredients. Thank you so much for watching. See you next time.